Hello everyone, welcome back to your GRE preparation with Infinity Education. Today in our 18th class, we will learn about the group or Venn diagram. So what is Venn diagram? Let us see. Suppose there is a group. In that group, a number of people are there. And there is one more group, group 2, and b number of people belongs from them. It may be possible there are a certain number of people who belongs from both the group. So we are considering that as C. And also it may also be possible that there are a certain number of people who do not belong from any of the group. So we are considering them as D. So now if I ask you, what will be the total number of people? So that should be A plus B minus C plus D. Why A plus B? Because A and B, they are the number of people in two different groups, and C is the number of people, those who belongs from both the groups. So they have been taken twice, one with A, one with B. So I have to subtract them once. Then also I have to consider D number of people because they have never been considered. So the formula we can also write as G1 plus G2 minus both plus neither. So this is a Venn diagram or grouping using two groups. Now what will happen if we are having three groups? Now let's see. If there is a group one where A number of people are there, group two where B number of people are there, and group three where C number of people are there. Like the previous one also, some of the people will belong from both of them. So if we are getting P number of people that belongs from both A and B, and Q number of people, those who belongs from both A and C, and R number of people, those who belongs from both B and C, so they have been considered twice. So I have to subtract them once. So I'm subtracting them. And there are a certain number of people, those who belongs from all the three groups, like we can see X number of people. So as they have been considered thrice, so to consider only once, I have to subtract them twice. So that's why it is minus of 2x. And like the two groups, if you are considering M number of people, those who do not belong from any of the group 1, 2, or 3, so we have to consider that also to get the total number of people. So if we sum up this formula, we are getting total equals to group 1 plus group 2 plus group 3 minus both exactly two set, like PQR, who belongs from exactly two set, minus two of all, like X number of people who belongs from all the groups, plus neither, like M, who is not belonging from any of the groups. I hope the grouping is clear to you. Now let's see with some of the examples. Of the 50 customers in an ice cream shop who have ordered cone, 24 of the customer have ordered the cone with vanilla flavor, and 12 have ordered cone with chocolate flavor, and 12 have ordered cone with both vanilla and chocolate flavor. How many of the customer have ordered cone with neither vanilla nor chocolate ice cream? So we know the formula total equals to group 1 plus group 2 minus both plus neither. Now, of the 50 customer in the ice cream shop, that means we are getting that 50 as a total. So I'm writing here, 24 of the customer have ordered the cone with vanilla flavor. Now this 24 I can consider as a group 1. So that's 24. 12 have ordered cone with chocolate flavor. So I'm considering 12 as group 2, so plus 12. And 12 have ordered cone with both vanilla and chocolate flavor. So I'm getting both as 12. So that's why minus 12. Now the question is, how many of the customers have ordered cone with neither vanilla nor chocolate ice cream? So I have to find out the neither. Now I can see plus 12 and minus 12, so I can eliminate. Now, as I have to find out the neither, that should be equals to 50 minus 24, which is 26. So D is the answer to the question. I hope the question is clear to you. Now let's see with one more example. At a sports day of 176 participants, 88 have taken eggs in lunch and 145 have tea in the morning. What is the greatest possible number of participants who could have both ordered in egg in lunch and tea in the morning? So similarly, we can use the formula that is total equals to group 1 plus group 2 minus both plus neither. So at the sports day of 176 participants, that means there is total 176. 88 have taken egg in lunch. So I am considering 88 as a group 1. So 88 here. 145 have tea in the morning. So I'm considering 145 as group 2. Now the question is, what is the greatest possible number of participants who could have both ordered egg in the lunch and tea in the morning? So I don't know both and neither. Now as the question is asking for what is the greatest number of participants who could have ordered both the things, so I know to get the maximum number of both, I have to decrease the number for neither. That's the minimum possible value, 0. So now if I'm considering neither as 0, so we are having the both value as 57. So that is the answer to the question. I'm repeating once again, because we are getting both equals to 233 minus 176 plus 0, or better to say neither. So to get the both as a maximum, neither have to be minimum, because the moment I'm increasing the neither value, so the both value will be decreased. So to get the maximum value for both, I will decrease the neither to the minimum value. So that's why I have considered the neither as 0, so that we are getting both equals to 57. I hope the question is clear to you. Now let's see with one more example. Of the 200 residents of Amar Street, 35% watch Hindi channel, 40% watch English channel, and 50% watch Bengali channel. If all residents watch at least one of the three channels and 18% watch exactly two of this show, then how many Amar Street residents watch all the three channels? So here we are getting three different groups. So we must utilize the bigger formula, that is total equals to group 1 plus group 2 plus group 3 minus both, that is exactly 2 set, minus 2 of all, like who is belonging from, or the number of set or number of people belonging from all the groups, plus neither. Now, of the 200 residents of Amar Street, so we can see the total as 200, but there is a percent. So we are considering the total as 100, so that our calculation will be easier. And whatever the output should be, I will just multiply that as 2, because the total residence is 200, but we are considering as 100 only. Now, 35% watch Hindi channel. So I'm considering Hindi channel people as group 1, that is 35. 40% watch English channel. So I'm considering 40% or the English channel as group 2. So I'm getting G2 as 40. 50% watch Bengali channel. So Bengali channel people I'm considering as group 3, so that I'm getting as 50. Now, if all resident watch at least one of the three channels, so that means I'm getting 0 people who are not watching anything, so the neither should be 0. And 18% watch exactly two of this, so. So we are getting 18 as both, so minus 18. Then the question is, then how many Amar Street resident watch all the three channels? So basically I need to find for all. So if we do the calculation, it will look like this: 100 equals to 35 plus 40 plus 50 minus 18, that is equals to 107, minus 2 of all. So we are having 2 of all equals to 107 minus 100, that equals to 7. So we are having all equals to 3.5. But that is not the answer, because our total resident was 200 and we have calculated on the basis of 100. So we have to multiply that with 2 to get the actual value. So E is the answer to the question. I hope the question is clear to you. Now let's see with one more example. A group of third graders and fourth grader is going on a field trip to the zoo. Only 20% of the students remember to bring written permission from their parents. If 40% of the students are third graders and 25% of the third graders remember to bring the written permission, what percent of the students are both fourth grader who forget to bring the written permission? So now, this is also another kind of a group question, and we can do the question without using that formula also. Now let's see how. We can see there is third grader, fourth grader, written permission, and without permission. So we are having two quantity with two different segment. So we can use a table like this. Third grader, fourth grader, written, without written, total and total. So as the question is consist of percent, so I am considering total as 100. Now I will do the question by small pieces. Only 20% of the student remembered to bring the written permission. So 20% of 100, that is 20. So 20 people has remembered to bring the written permission. So without written is how much? 100 minus 20, that is 80. Next, if 40% of the student are third graders, so obviously out of total. So if 40% of the student is third grader out of 100, so third grader should be 40. Because 40% of 100 is 40. So obviously we need not to say the remaining are fourth grader. So fourth grader should be 60, because 100 minus 40 equals to 60. And 25% of the third grader remember to bring the written permission. So 20% of third grader, that means 20% of 40. So 25% of 40, they remember to bring the permission. So 25% of 40 is 10. So 10 number of people of third grader, they remember to bring the written permission. Now, if you are having that 10 as third grader with written, so we are getting third grader without written is 30, and fourth grader with written as 10, because we know written is 20 altogether. So if we are having 10 people of third grader, so obviously fourth grader should be 10 people with written. So similarly, we are having 50 also. By the same logic, now the question is, what percent of the student are fourth grader who forgot to bring the written permission? So without permission and also fourth grader. So we are getting C is the answer to the question. I hope the thing is clear. Now, after doing all these four questions, I believe your grouping related question regarding the Venn diagram is clear to you. Now, if you have any doubts regarding today's class, or if you are practicing from any other sources, from any other elsewhere, you can always come back to us with your doubt. Thank you, everyone. Happy learning.